Hi, let's talk about the lacrimal apparatus. Also known as the lacrimal system, this is the pathway by which tears are secreted, drawn across the eye, and drained. And so our story starts here with the lacrimal gland. The lacrimal gland secretes into the conjunctival sac. The conjunctival sac, if you recall, consists of palpebral conjunctiva and bulbar conjunctiva. It's the space between these features. And this lacrimal fluid, or tears, are drawn across the anterior aspect of the eye medially. So we're looking, that's a medial, and that is a lateral portion, and we can see that the lacrimal gland sits in the superolateral portion of the orbit. These tears, as they are drawn medially across the eye, some are absorbed by the conjunctiva, some evaporate from the surface of the eye, but most accumulate in an area over the medial canthus, and that accumulation of tears is known as the lacrimal lake. Deep to that accumulation of tears, we can see an elevation of tissue. This elevation of tissue contains both sebaceous and, interestingly enough, some sudoriferous glands. And it's known as the lacrimal caruncle. So in the mornings when you wake up, if you ever wipe the medial canthi of your eyes and you notice that there is an accumulation of a substance, perhaps you call it sleep or eye boogers or gunk or whatever, those are secretions from the glands of the lacrimal caruncle. Anyways, embedded in the eyelids, so the superior and inferior eyelids going out are going to be canaliculi, and these little canals are going to drain tears even deeper. So sitting and feeding into these canals are lacrimal papillae. These are elevations, and these papillae host the lacrimal puncta. So the lacrimal puncta are what feed into the lacrimal canaliculi, or canals. And we'll be able to see that better in just a moment. But I wanted to show you all a living donor here. So we can see the accumulation of tears here. So that's the lacrimal lake. And the border of the lacrimal lake, so there's a membrane here called the Leaky semilunaris. This is a vestige of our third eyelid. And what it is just an infolding of the bulbar conjunctiva that allows for a more free range of motion of the eye. In some animals, some species of primates, reptiles such as birds and some lizards, as well as sharks, this membrane is a nictitating membrane that can cover nearly the entirety of the eye and moisten it and protect it while still maintaining some transparency so that the organism can see through it. In humans, we're left with just this little vestige of it, and allows us to move the eye, and it also helps to maintain the lacrimal lake. So here, deep to these tears, or the lacrimal lake, is the caruncle. So we can see that collection of glandular materials. And we can also see, at least on the inferior palpebrae here, this would be the inferior lacrimal papilla. We can't see the superior one, but it's probably about in this area, just on the conjunctival side of the superior palpebrae there. And so that inferior pupilla hosts the inferior lacrimal puncta. So those are feeding into the canaliculi, which very typically come together and then are going to drain into the lacrimal sac. So here we have more of that dissected away, and we can see the inferior canaliculus there, the superior there, and these are coming together in a common trunk, which is most often the case, but they can drain independently into the lacrimal sac. You can see that lacrimal sac here sitting in the lacrimal fossa of the lacrimal bone. And so this sac is going to be contiguous with the nasolacrimal duct. And the nasolacrimal duct is going to conduct the tears down into the nasal cavity. So as to help moisten the nasal mucosa as well. And so that this lacrimal tears don't spill down the surface of our face, which is very efficient. There's also a part of orbicularis oculi, known as the lacrimal part, that overlies this sac. And what happens when this muscle contracts, the sac is squeezed. So it exerts pressure on the sac, and then it relieves. So it's like a squeeze bulb. So when you squeeze it, it can push the tears in. But then when that muscle releases, it causes a suction effect to drain the tears from the lacrimal lake into the lacrimal puncta on the papillae. So that is how tears move from the lacrimal gland through the lacrimal system into the nasal cavity. Thank you very much for your time.